combination of these titles. Our Lady of Fatima, Portuguese, Nossa Senhora. Our Lady of Fatima in the Chapel of Apparition. For other uses, see Fatima, disambiguation, Our Lady of Fatima, Our Lady of Fatima in the Chapel of Apparitions, location Fatima. Portugal, date May 13th, October 13th, 1917, witness Lasha Santos Jacinta and Francis Carmarto type Marian apparition, Holy See approval 1930. During the pontificate of Pope Pius X, shrine sanctuary of Our Lady of Fatima, Fatima, Portugal, Our Lady of Fatima, Portuguese, Nossa Senhora de Fatima, European Portuguese, NSO de Fatim, 1. Is the title based on apparitions to three shepherd children at Fatima, Portugal, on the 13th day of six consecutive months in 1917, beginning on May 13th. The three children were Lasha Santos and her cousins Jacinta and Francis Carmarto. The apparition is also referred to as Our Lady of the Rosary, a term first used in 1208 for the reputed apparition in the Church of Proil. Because the children said the apparition called herself the Lady of the Rosary. A combination of these titles is also seen. That is Our Lady of the Rosary of Fatima, Nossa Senhora do Rosario de Fatima. The events at Fatima gained fame due to elements of secrets, prophecy and eschatology, particularly with regard to World War II and possible world wars in the future. Chief among these is also the alleged urgent need for the consecration of Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. The reported apparitions at Fatima were officially declared worthy of belief by the Catholic Church. The Blessed Jacinta and Francis Carmarto and the apparitions of Pontevedra. Contents history, initial apparitions, miracle of the sun, three secrets of Fatima, first two secrets, fate of the three children, consecration of Russia, third secret, controversy around the third secret, Fatima prayers and reparations, pilgrimage, political aspects, official position of the Catholic Church, popes and Fatima. See also references, footnotes, bibliography, external links, history edit, location of Fatima, Portugal. Three Portuguese children, Lucia dos Santos, Jacinta Mardo, and Francisco Mardo, were young and without much education when they reported the apparition of Our Lady of Fatima in 1917. The local administrator initially jailed the children and threatened that he would boil them one by one in a pot of oil. The children were consoled by the other inmates in the jail, and then led the inmates in praying the rosary. 2, 3. With millions of followers and Roman Catholic believers, the reported visions at Fatima gathered respect. After a canonical inquiry, the visions of Fatima were officially declared worthy of belief in October 1930 by the Bishop of Laria Fatima. 4. Popes Pius II, John 23, Paul VI, John Paul II and Benedict XV voiced their acceptance of the supernatural origin of the Fatima events. John Paul II credited Our Lady of Fatima with saving his life following an assassination attempt on the feast of Our Lady of Fatima, 1981. He donated a bullet that wounded him to the Roman Catholic sanctuary at Fatima, Portugal. 3. Initial apparitions in the spring and summer of 1916. 9-year-old Lasha Santos and her cousins Jacinta and Francisco Marta were herding sheep at the Cova da Iria near their home village of Fatima, Portugal. They claimed to have experienced the visitation of an angel on 3 separate occasions. The angel taught them prayers to pray, to make sacrifices, and to spend time in adoration of the Lord. 5. On May 13, 1917, Lasha described seeing a lady brighter than the sun, shedding rays of light clearer and stronger than a crystal goblet filled with the most sparkling water and pierced by the burning rays of the sun. While they had never spoken to anyone about the angel, Jacinta divulged her sightings to her family despite Lucia's admonition to keep this experience private. Her disbelieving mother told neighbors as a joke, and within a day the whole village knew. 6. Further appearances were reported on June 13th and July 13th. In these, the lady asked the children to do penance and acts of reparation and make personal sacrifices to save sinners. According to Lasha's account, the lady also confided to the children 3 secrets, now known as the 3 secrets of Fatima. The children subsequently wore tight cords around their waists, performed self-flagellation using stinging nettles, abstained from drinking water on hot days, and performed other works of penance. 6. Thousands of people flocked to Fatima and Al Jestral in the following months, drawn by reports of visions and miracles. On August 13, 1917, the provincial administrator Artur Santos, 7, no relation to Lasha Santos, believing that the events were politically disrupted, intercepted and jailed the children before they could reach the Cova da Iria. The administrator interrogated and threatened the children to get him to divulge the contents of the secrets. Lasha told him everything short of the secrets, and offered to ask the lady for permission to tell the administrator the secrets. 8. Prisoners held with them in the provincial jail later testified that the children led them in praying the rosary that month, instead of the usual apparition in the Cova da Iria on the 13th. The children reported that they saw the Virgin Mary on August 15th, the Feast of the Assumption, at nearby Valinhas. 6. Miracle of the Sun. Main article. Miracle of the Sun. Chapel of Apparitions. Built at the place where the Fatima apparitions were reported. Page from Ilustração Portuguesa, October 29, 1917. Showing the people looking at the sun during the Fatima apparitions attributed to the Virgin Mary. As early as July 1917 it was claimed that the Virgin Mary had promised a miracle for the last of her apparitions on October 13th, so that all would believe. What happened then became known as the Miracle of the Sun. A huge crowd, variously estimated between 30,000 and 100,000. 9. Including newspaper reporters and photographers, gathered at the Cova da Iria. The incessant rain had ceased and there was a thin layer of cloud. Lasha, seeing light rising from the lady's hands and the sun appearing as a silver disc, called out, "Look at the sun." She later had no memory of saying this. 6. Witnesses later spoke of the sun appearing to change colors and rotate like a wheel. 10. Witnesses gave widely varying descriptions of the son's dance. Poet Afonso Lopez Vieira and school teacher Delfina Lopez with her students and other witnesses in the town of Albureta reported that the solar phenomenon was visible up to 40 kilometers away. 10. Columnist Avelino de Almeida Voz de Culo, Portugal's most influential newspaper, which was pro-government in policy and avowedly anti-clerical. 6. Reported the following. Before the astonished eyes of the crowd, whose aspect was biblical as they stood bareheaded, eagerly searching the sky, the sun trembled, made sudden incredible movements outside all cosmic laws. The sun danced according to the typical expression of the people. 11. Eye specialist Dr. Domingos Pinto Coelho, writing for the newspaper Ordem, reported the sun, at one moment surrounded with scarlet flame, at another aureoled in yellow and deep purple, seemed to be in an exceeding fast and whirling movement, at times appearing to be loosened from the sky and to be approaching the earth, strongly radiating heat. 12. The special reporter for the October 17, 1917 edition of the Lisbon Daily, Odia, reported the following. The silver sun, enveloped in the same gauzy purple light, was seen to whirl and turn in the circle of broken clouds. The light turned a beautiful blue, as if it had come through the stained glass windows of a cathedral, and spread itself over the people who knelt with outstretched hands. People wept and prayed with uncovered heads, in the presence of a miracle they had awaited. The seconds seemed like hours, so vivid were they. 13. No movement or other phenomenon of the sun was recorded by scientists at the time. 6. Not all witnesses reported seeing the sun dance. Some people only saw the radiant colors, and others, including some believers, saw nothing at all. 14. 15. Various explanations have been advanced. Augusto Meissen, a professor at the Institute of Physics, Catholic University of Leuven, points out that looking directly at the sun is known to cause phosphine visual artifacts and temporary partial blindness. Meissen contends that retinal after image is produced after brief periods of sun gazing are a likely cause of the dancing effects, and the color changes were caused by the bleaching of photosensitive retinal cells. 16. Meissen observes that solar miracles have been witnessed in many places where people have been encouraged to stare at the sun. He cites the apparitions at Haroldsbach, Bavaria, Germany, 1949, as an example where exactly the same optical effects as at Fatima were witnessed by more than 10,000 people. 16. Another theory is a mass hallucination stimulated by the religious fervor of the crowd. Some onlookers reported other phenomena, including luminous mist and the showers of flower petals seen around and above the tree during previous visitations, while the crowd was staring at the sun. Lucia, Francisco, and Jacinta said later they saw images of the Holy Family, Our Lady of Sorrows with Jesus Christ, and then Our Lady of Mount Carmel. They said they saw Saint Joseph and Jesus bless the people. 17. The second secret predicted a great sign in the night sky which would precede a second great war. 18. 19. On January 25, 1938, bright lights, an aurora borealis, appeared all over the northern hemisphere, including in places as far south as North Africa, Bermuda, and California. 18. 19. It was the widest occurrence of the aurora since 1709. 20. And people in Paris and elsewhere believed a great fire was burning and fire departments were called. 21. Lasha, the sole surviving seer at the time, indicated that it was the sign foretold and so apprised her superior and the bishop in letters the following day. 18. 19. Just over a month later, Hitler seized Austria and 8 months later invaded Czechoslovakia. 18. 19. Three Secrets of Fatima Edit. Main article. Three Secrets of Fatima. First two secrets. Lasha Santos left with her cousins Jacinta and Francisco Mardo. 1917. The first secret was a vision of hell. which Lasha describes in her third memoir as follows. Our Lady showed us a great sea of fire which seemed to be under the earth. Plunged in this fire were demons and souls in human form, like transparent burning embers, all blackened or burnished bronze, floating about in the conflagration, now raised into the air by the flames that issued from within themselves together with great clouds of smoke, now falling back on every side like sparks in a huge fire, without weight or equilibrium, and amid shrieks and groans of pain and despair, which horrified us and made us tremble with fear. The demons could be distinguished by their terrifying and repulsive likeness to frightful and unknown animals, all black and transparent. This vision lasted but an instant. How can we ever be grateful enough to our kind Heavenly Mother, who had already prepared us by promising, in the first apparition, to take us to heaven? Otherwise, I think we would have died of fear and terror. 22. The second secret included Mary's instructions on how to save souls from hell and convey out the world to the Christian faith, also revealed by Lasha in her third memoir. You have seen hell where the souls of poor sinners go. To save them, God wishes to establish in the world devotion to my Immaculate Heart. If what I say to you is done, many souls will be saved and there will be peace. The war is going to end. But if people do not cease offending God, a worse one will break up during the pontificate of Pius II. When you see a night illuminated by an unknown light, know that this is the great sign given you by God that He is about to punish the world for its crimes, by means of war, famine, and persecutions of the Church and of the Holy Father. To prevent this, I shall come to ask for the consecration of Russia to my Immaculate Heart, and the communion of reparation on the first Saturdays. If my requests are heeded, Russia will be converted, and there will be peace. If not, she will spread her errors throughout the world, causing wars and persecutions of the Church. The good will be martyred. The Holy Father will have much to suffer. Various nations will be annihilated. In the end, my Immaculate Heart will triumph. The Holy Father will consecrate Russia to me, and she shall be converted, and a period of peace will be granted to the world. 23. Fate of the three children. Further information. Pontificate apparitions and First Saturday devotions. Statue depicting the Immaculate Heart of Mary is described by Sister Lasha. Lasha became a postulant at the Dorothean convent in Tully or Tully, Galicia in 1928, Francisco, 1908-1919, and Jacinta Mardo, 1910-1920, were both victims of the great Spanish flu epidemic of 1918-1920. Francisco and Jacinta were declared venerable by Pope John Paul II in a public ceremony at Fatima on May 13, 1989. He returned there on May 13, 2000 to declare them blessed, a title of veneration below that of sainthood. See canonization. Jacinta is the youngest non-martyred child ever to be beatified. Sister Lasha reported seeing the Virgin Mary again in 1925 at the Dorothean convent at Pontevedra, Galicia, Spain. This time she said she was asked to convey the message of the First Saturday devotions. By her account, a subsequent vision of Christ as a child reiterated this request. In 1929, she reported that Mary returned and repeated her request for the consecration of Russia to her Immaculate Heart. Sister Lasha reportedly saw Mary in private visions periodically throughout her life. Most significant was the apparition in Rianxo, Galicia, in 1931, in which she said that Jesus visited her, taught her two prayers and delivered a message to give to the Church's hierarchy. In 1947, Sister Lasha left the Dorothean order and joined the Discalced Carmelite order in a monastery in Coimbra, Portugal. Lasha died on February 13, 2005, at the age of 97. After her death, Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger, head of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, and later to become Pope Benedict XII, ordered her cell sealed off. It is believed this was because the evidence needed to be examined in the course of proceedings for her possible canonization. 24. In 1936 and again in 1941, Sister Lasha claimed that the Virgin Mary had predicted the deaths of two of the children during the second apparition on June 13, 1917. Olympia Mardo, mother of the two younger children, and others state that her children ecstatically predicted their own deaths many times to her and to curious pilgrims. 25. In fact, it was the first thing Jacinta told her mother when she spoke to her after the initial apparition. 26. According to the 1941 account, on June 13, Lasha asked the Virgin if the three children would go to heaven when they died. She said that she heard Mary reply, "Yes, I shall take Francisco and Jacinta soon, but you will remain a little longer, since Jesus wishes you to make me known and loved on earth. He wishes also for you to establish devotion in the world to my Immaculate Heart." 27. Exhumed in 1935 and again in 1951, Jacinta's face was found incorrupt or immune to decay. Francisco's body, however, had decomposed. 28. Consecration of Russia. Main articles. Consecration of Russia. Pope Pius II. Consecration to the Immaculate Heart of Mary and Sacro Virgin. Statue of Pope Pius II in Fatima, Portugal. Just as a few years ago we consecrated the entire human race to the Immaculate Heart of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, so today we consecrate and in a most special manner we entrust all the peoples of Russia to this Immaculate Heart. According to Sister Lasha, the Virgin Mary promised that the consecration of Russia would lead to Russia's conversion and an era of peace. 6. Pope Pius II, in his apostolic letter Sacro Virgint of July 7, 1952, consecrated Russia to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Pius II wrote, "Just as a few years ago we consecrated the entire human race to the Immaculate Heart of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, so today we consecrate and in a most special manner we entrust all the peoples of Russia to this Immaculate Heart." 29. In 1952 the Pope said to the Russian people in a Stalinist regime that the Virgin Mary was always victorious. "The gates of hell will never prevail. Where she offers her protection, she is the good mother, the mother of all, and it has never been heard that those who seek her protection will not receive it." With this certainty, the Pope dedicates all people of Russia to the Immaculate Heart of the Virgin. She will help. Error and atheism will be overcome with her assistance and divine grace. 30. Popes Pius II and John Paul II both had a special relationship with Our Lady of Fatima. Pope Benedict XV began Pacelli's church career, elevating him to Archbishop in the Sistine Chapel on May 13, 1917, the date of the first reported apparition. Pius II was laid to rest in the crypt of St. Peter's Basilica on October 13, 1958, the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima. Pope John Paul II again consecrated the entire world to the Virgin Mary in 1984, without explicitly mentioning Russia. Some believe that Sister Lasha verified that this ceremony fulfilled the requests of the Virgin Mary. 31. However, in the Blue Army's Spanish magazine, Sol de Fatima, in the September 1985 issue, Sister Lasha said that the ceremony did not fulfill the Virgin Mary's request, as there was no specific mention of Russia, and many bishops attached no importance to it. In 2001, Archbishop Tarcisio Burdon issued a statement, claiming that he had met with Sister Lasha, who reportedly told him, "I have already said that the consecration desired by Our Lady was made in 1984, and has been accepted in heaven." Sister Lasha died on February 13, 2005, without making any public statement of her own to settle the issue. Some maintain that, according to Lasha and Fatima advocates such as Abbe Georges Benetz, Fr. Paul Kramer and Nicholas Gruner, Russia has never been specifically consecrated to the Immaculate Heart of Mary by any pope simultaneously with all the world's bishops. which is what Lasha in the 1985 interview had said Mary had asked for, 32, 33, 34. However, by letters of August 29, 1989 and July 3, 1990, she stated that the consecration had been completed. Indeed, in the 1990 letter in response to a question by Reverend Father Robert J. Fox, she confirmed, "I come to answer your question. If the consecration made by Pope John Paul II on March 25, 1984 in union with all the bishops of the world, accomplished the conditions for the consecration of Russia according to the request of Our Lady and Tui on June 13 of 1929, yes, it was accomplished. And since then I have said that it was made, and I say that no other person responds for me. It is I who receive and open all letters and respond to them. 35. In the meantime, the conception of Theotokos Hefnea Orthodox Christian Venerated Icon points out that Virgin Mary is considered actual Tsarina of Russia by the religious appeal of Nicholas II. Thus consecration of Russia may refer to return of Russian monarchy. The icon was brought to Fatima in 2003 and 2014, together with another significant Theotokos of Port Arthur icon. 36. Third Secret. The Third Secret, a vision of the death of the Pope and other religious figures, was transcribed by the Bishop of Leiria and reads, after the two parts which I have already explained, at the left of Our Lady and a little above, we saw an angel with a flaming sword in his left hand, flashing. It gave out flames that looked as though they would set the world on fire, but they died out in contact with the splendor that Our Lady radiated towards him from her right hand. Pointing to the earth with his right hand, the angel cried out in a loud voice, penance, 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 and we saw in an immense light that is God. Something similar to how people appear in a mirror when they pass in front of it. A bishop dressed in white, we had the impression that it was the Holy Father. Other bishops, priests, religious men and women going up a steep mountain, at the top of which there was a big cross of rough-hewn trunks as of a cork tree with the bark. Before reaching there, the Holy Father passed through a big city half in ruins and half trembling with halting step, afflicted with pain and sorrow. He prayed for the souls of the corpses he met on his way. Having reached the top of the mountain, on his knees at the foot of the big cross, he was killed by a group of soldiers who fired bullets and arrows at him. And in the same way there died one after another the other bishops, priests, religious men and women, and various lay people of different ranks and positions. Beneath the two arms of the cross there were two angels, each with a crystal aspersorium in his hand, in which they gathered up the blood of the martyrs and with it sprinkled the souls that were making their way to God. 37. Controversy around the Third Secret. Main article. Third Secret of Fatima controversy. Lasha declared that the Third Secret could be released to the public after 1960. Some sources, including Canon Barthes and Cardinal Ottaviani, said that Lasha insisted to them it must be released by 1960, saying that, by that time, it will be more clearly understood, and, because the Blessed Virgin wishes it so. 38. 39. Instead, in 1960 the Vatican published an official press release stating that it was most probable the secret would remain, forever, under absolute seal. 40. This announcement triggered widespread speculation. According to the New York Times, speculation over the content of the secret ranged from worldwide nuclear annihilation to deep rifts in the Roman Catholic Church that lead to rival papacies. 41. The Vatican withheld the Third Secret until June 26, 2000. Even then, some sources believe that at the four-page, handwritten text, 42, of the Third Secret released by the Vatican in the year 2000 is not the full text of the secret. 43, 44, 45, 46, some allege that Cardinals Burdone, Ratzinger and Saldana conceal the existence of another, one-page document, containing information about the apocalypse and a great apostasy. 43, 44, 45, The Vatican has maintained its position that the full text of the third secret was published, according to a December 2001 Vatican press release, subsequently published in L'Osservatore Romano. Lascia told then Archbishop Tarcisio Bertone in an interview that the secret had been completely revealed and published, 47, 48, 49, during his apostolic visit to Portugal between May 11 and 14, 2010 on the 10th anniversary of the beatification of Jacinta and Francisco Mardo, 50. Pope Benedict XVI explained to reporters that the interpretation of the third secret did not necessarily refer to the attempted assassination of Pope John Paul II in St. Peter's Square in 1981. The third secret of Fatima, said Benedict XVI, has a permanent and ongoing significance, and that its significance could even be extended to include the suffering the Church is going through today as a result of the recent reports of sexual abuse involving the clergy. 51. Fatima prayers and reparations edit. Many Roman Catholics recite prayers based on Our Lady of Fatima. Lascia later said that, in 1916, she and her cousins had several visions of an angel calling himself the Angel of Portugal and the Angel of Peace, who taught them to bow with their heads to the ground and to say, "My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love you. I ask pardon for those who do not believe, do not adore, do not hope, and do not love you." Lascia later set this prayer to music, and a recording exists of her singing it. 52. It was also said that sometime later the angel returned and taught them a Eucharistic devotion now known as the Angel Prayer. 53. 54. Lascia said that the Lady emphasized acts of reparation and prayers to console Jesus for the sins of the world. Lascia said that Mary's words were, "When you make some sacrifice, say, O Jesus, it is for your love, for the conversion of sinners, and in reparation for sins committed against the Immaculate Heart of Mary at the first apparition." Lascia wrote, "The children were so moved by the radiance they perceived that they involuntarily said, 'Most Holy Trinity, I adore you, my God, I love you in the most blessed sacrament.'" 55. Lascia also said that she heard Mary ask for these words to be added to the rosary after the Gloria Patri prayer. "O my Jesus, pardon us, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need." 56. In the tradition of Marian visitations, the conversion of sinners is not necessarily religious conversion to the Roman Catholic Church, for that would be the conversion of heretics or apostates who are outside the Church and alien to the Christian faith, according to Pope Leo XII in his encyclical on the unity of the Church, Satis Cognitum. Conversion of sinners refers to general repentance and attempt to amend one's life according to the teachings of Jesus for those true Catholics who do profess the faith truly, but are fallen into sins. Lascia wrote that she and her cousins define sinners not as non-Catholics but as those who had fallen away from the Church or, more specifically, willfully indulged in sinful activity, particularly sins of the flesh, 57, and acts of injustice and a lack of charity towards the poor, widows and orphans, the ignorant and the helpless, which she said were even worse than sins of impurity, 58, pilgrimage edit. The sanctuary of Our Lady of Fatima is one of the largest Marian shrines in the world. An estimated 70,000 people assembled to witness the last of the promised appearances of the Lady in the Cova d'Iria on October 13, 1917. The widely reported miracle of the sun was a factor that led to Fatima quickly becoming a major center of pilgrimage. 2 million pilgrims visited the site in the decade following the events of 1917. 59. A small chapel, the Capelinha, was built by local people on the site of the apparitions. The construction was neither encouraged nor hindered by the Catholic Church authorities. On May 13, 1920, pilgrims defied government troops to install a statue of the Virgin Mary in the chapel. 60. And the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass was first officially celebrated there in January 1924. A hostel for the sick was begun in the year. In 1927 the first rector of the sanctuary was appointed and a set of stations of the cross were erected on the mountain road. The foundation stone for the present basilica was laid the next year. 61. 1930 was the year both of official church recognition of the apparition events as worthy of belief and the granting of a papal indulgence to pilgrims visiting Fatima. In 1935 the bodies of the visionaries Jacinta and Francisco were reinterred in the basilica. The coronation of the statue of Our Lady of Fatima there in 1946 drew such large crowds that the entrance to the site had to be barred. 62. Today pilgrimage to the site goes on all year round and additional chapels, hospitals and other facilities have been constructed. The principal pilgrimage festivals take place on the 13th day of each month, from May to October. On the anniversaries of the original appearances, the largest crowds gather on May 13th and October 13th. When up to 1 million pilgrims have attended to pray and witness processions of the statue of Our Lady of Fatima, both during the day and by the light of tens of thousands of candles at night. 63. Political aspects added. The devotion to Our Lady of Fatima in the Roman Catholic Church has a long history of association with rightist and even fascist groups. This is attributable to the timing of the publication of Sister Lucia's memoirs after the outbreak of WW2 and the focus on Russia and her errors in the alleged messages of the Lady. The Blue Army of Our Lady, for instance, has always been strongly anti-communist and often put the Fatima story into the context of the Cold War. The Blue Army is made up of Catholics and non-Catholics who believe that by dedicating themselves to daily prayer, specifically, of the Rosary, they can help to achieve world peace and put an end to the era of communism. Our Lady of Fatima was often presented in Catholic literature as leading a crusade against communism. As the forces of the Republic gathered strength in Spain, the Virgin Mary was to be found leading the armies of the faithful ranged against the godless. 64. During the Spanish Second Republic, the Virgin Mary would be seen on Spanish soil at Azcuiga. Ramona Olazabal insisted Mary had marked the palms of her hands with a sword. Seers gained much credence in integrist and Carlist circles. The visions at Azcuiga were widely covered in the press, as were the 16 other visitations of the Virgin to Spain in 1931. Conservative elements in the Spanish Church actively encouraged the Fatima devotion as a way of countering the perceived threat of atheistic communism. In Portugal and its former colony of Brazil, Fatima and right-wing groups were also strongly identified. When Hitler invaded Russia in 1941, many Catholics interpreted this in terms of the Fatima apparitions, thinking the Virgin's prophecy at long last was about to be fulfilled. Some Catholics willingly joined the fight and enlisted in the Spanish Army's Blue Division that was engaged on the Eastern Front. Official position of the Catholic Church added, inside the Basilica of the Rosary, private revelations do not form part of the deposit of faith of the Catholic Church, and its members are not bound to believe in any of them. However, as a matter of prudence, assent would normally be expected of a Catholic based on the discernment of the Church and its judgment that an apparition is worthy of belief. 65. 66. After a canonical inquiry, the visions of Fatima were officially declared worthy of belief in October 1930 by the Bishop of Leiria Fatima. 67. Popes and Fatima edit. Ecclesiastical approbation does not imply that the Church provides an infallible guarantee on the supernatural nature of the event. Theologians like Karl Rahner argued, however, that popes, by authoritatively fostering the Marian veneration in places as Fatima and Lourdes, motivate the faithful into an acceptance of divine faith. 68. Popes Pius VI, Paul VI, John Paul II and Benedict XVI all voiced their acceptance of the supernatural origin of the Fatima events in unusually clear and strong terms, after the local bishop had declared that, 1. The visions of the three children are credible and, 2. The veneration of the Blessed Virgin is permitted, The Portuguese bishops approved and declared the genuine supernatural nature of the event. The Vatican responded with granting indulgences and permitting special liturgies of the Mass to be celebrated in Fatima, 16. In 1939, Eugenio Pacelli, who was consecrated as a bishop on May 13, 1917, the day of the first apparition, was elected to the papacy as POCI, and became the Pope of Fatima, 69, 1 year after World War II had started. Sister Lasha asked Pope POCI to consecrate the world and Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. She repeated this request on December 2, 1940, stating in the year 1929, the Blessed Lady requested in another apparition the consecration of Russia to her Immaculate Heart. She promised the conversion of Russia from its errors. Statue depicting Our Lady of Fatima, on May 13, 1942. The 25th anniversary of the first apparition and the silver jubilee of the episcopal consecration of Pope POCI, the Vatican published the Message and Secret of Fatima. On October 31, 1942, Pope POCI, in a radio address, informed the people of Portugal about the apparitions of Fatima, consecrating the human race to the Immaculate Heart of the Virgin with specific mention of Russia, see below. 70. On December 8, 1942, the pontiff officially and solemnly declared this consecration in a ceremony in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome. On May 13, 1946, Cardinal Massala, the personal delegate of POCI, crowned in his name Our Lady of Fatima, as the Pope issued a second message about Fatima. The faithful Virgin never disappointed the trust put on her. She will transform into a fountain of graces, physical and spiritual graces, over all of Portugal, and from there, breaking all frontiers, over the whole church and the entire world. 71. On May 1, 1948, in auspicia quietam, Pope POCI requested the consecration to the Immaculate Heart of every Catholic family, parish and diocese. It is our wish, consequently, that wherever the opportunity suggests itself, this consecration be made in the various dioceses as well as in each of the parishes and families. 72. 73. On May 18, 1950, the Pope again sent a message to the people of Portugal regarding Fatima. May Portugal never forget the heavenly message of Fatima, which, before anybody else, she was blessed to hear. To keep Fatima in your heart and to translate Fatima into deeds is the best guarantee for evermore graces. 74. In numerous additional messages, and in his encyclical Fulgens Corona, 1953, and Aquilae Regina, 1954, POCI encouraged the veneration of the Virgin in Fatima. At the end of the Second Vatican Council, Pope Paul VI renewed the consecration of POCI to the Immaculate Heart of Mary and, in an unusual gesture, announced his own pilgrimage to the sanctuary on the 50th anniversary of the first apparition. On May 13, 1967, he prayed at the shrine together with Sister Lasha. This historic gesture further cemented the official support for Fatima. Pope John Paul II credited Our Lady of Fatima with saving his life following the assassination attempt on Wednesday, May 13, the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima, in 1981-42. He followed the footsteps of Paul VI on May 12, 1987, to express his gratitude to the Virgin Mary for saving his life. The following day, he renewed the consecration of POCI to the Immaculate Heart of the Virgin. 16. On May 12 and 13, 2010, Pope Benedict XV visited the sanctuary of Our Lady of Fatima and strongly stated his acceptance of the supernatural origin of the Fatima apparitions. On the first day, the Pope arrived at the Chapel of Apparitions to pray and gave a golden rose to Our Lady of Fatima as a homage of gratitude from the Pope for the marvels that the Almighty has worked through you in the hearts of so many who come as pilgrims to this your maternal home. The Pope also recalled the invisible hand that saved John Paul II and said in a prayer to the Blessed Virgin Mary that it is a profound consolation to know that you are crowned not only with the silver and gold of our joys and hopes, but also with the bullet of our anxieties and sufferings. 75. On the second day, Pope Benedict's homily pronounced in front of more than 500,000 pilgrims a reference to the Fatima prophecy about the triumph of the Immaculate Heart of Mary and related it to the final glory of the Most Holy Trinity. 76. 77.